Welcome guys to another Born Again. If you haven't liked or subscribed, what are you waiting for? Spring is well on the way. It's almost May and today we're going to be growing cash crops, saving us a bit of cash. Because eating healthy, unfortunately, costs more than the Mackey D's, isn't it? A big motivator for you guys at home is going to be the sheer amount of money you save. In my family at home, there's four of us. And we're spending at least 20 plus pounds per week on just leaves. Having grown up tending to my own vegetable garden, it's really clear to me like a lot of these greens are really easy to grow. Like spinach, when it's a fully grown plant, is essentially a weed. You can't get rid of it. On the flip side, I got some old scaffolding boards. Didn't even buy any compost, but I should have. And just spent £6.75 on seeds. And that's it. Oh, of course my labour, but I enjoy it. Spending £20 on green leaves a week, that's £80 a month, £320 through one growing season, which includes May, June, July and August. Usually it's a bit longer, but we're in the UK, so round down. Confused? Come on. So why not have a raised bed in your garden, low maintenance, and be picking the vegetables just before you eat them? Look at that, that's disgusting. It's a dead pigeon in the undergrowth. That's why you clean up so you don't... Ugh. No one likes hard labour, but it gets you outside into the sun, so part of your vitamin D schedule, but also it earths you and like gets rid of all the static from your body and just makes you feel positive. Raised beds are amazing because they hold moisture really well, unlike pots, where in the summer, if the pots bake in the summer sun, they dry out completely and just shock the plant. I don't throw away foliage or wood because I want the nutrients to always go back into the ground. But honestly, don't make excuses to not do anything, you know, starting small is the best. The soil behind me hasn't been dug or turned for so many years, it's really compacted. Another reason why it's so hard is because it hasn't actually rained for about 2-3 weeks. And now it's sunset. I'm going to get a hose and literally water all the soil so the soil just softens up. When the soil is slightly wet, it's actually fairly workable. It's not gonna be really hot at night for the water to evaporate. So instead it's actually gonna settle and then seep into the ground. Remember, we wanna get the soil to be as fluffy as possible, just like when you get it in the garden center. It really depends where you're digging. The topsoil isn't very deep here, so I ended up using a lady's fork, which is not as long as the typical fork, so I wasn't hitting the bedrock, which just made it easier to dig. Because I haven't got a vehicle to get manure for this raised bed, I'm actually kind of recycling all the topsoil from around the bed. This soil is really dark, so the darker it is, the more nutrients it holds, and also it's not really been used to grow anything, so relatively speaking, it's fairly rested. This is the exact point you need a rake to level the soil, to break it up, to make it more fine, but I'm not making that an excuse not to do this project. the sun, it feels like summer, but then you get a cloud and it's like, okay, wait, spring. I swear to God, I don't know what to wear in the British weather. Every day I have to wear something different, and every 2 hours as well. I've got a cold for the last like 2-3 weeks. I'm tired of being a hermit sitting inside all day. It's just so depressing. When you get out, and especially when you're growing your own food, it's almost like a spiritual moment. When you can grow it by yourself from seed, then that's when you realize what real food tastes like. And did I mention, when you grow it yourself, it's basically organic by default, and you appreciate the food a lot more and you throw it away less. I genuinely almost forgot about this. Getting organized with gardening makes it just more enjoyable. It's nice to remember before the plants get really big, which row is which, compared to having to like try to memorize it, which is just a bit annoying kind of thing. No tools. You don't want to cover the seeds more than about a centimeter, really, just enough to cover the seed. Don't forget to water them seeds in, guys. And I'm putting some plastic over the raised bed, so when the sun comes, if any, during the day, it will warm the soil up, like the greenhouse effect, which really should just make the seed germination process a lot faster, especially because of the cold nights and cold days when there's no sun. Because remember, the worst thing is having to sow your seeds the second time because they ain't come up the first time. For more gardening tips, stay tuned, but also check out Rob's allotment. He's the winner from the Big Allotment Challenge. He beat me, so he must be good.